commerce is always the better choice. The reason is the money and the time, the value, what exactly you people need to know. We're gonna give you all model question papers, complete blueprint. We are equipped. Where you are supposed to be a little more careful, where you are supposed to be very smart, so that you will understand everything. You should only concentrate on the chapters which you are comfortable with. A sure assurance from Abhilash sir, because I'll teach you how to get the center in a very smart way. Hello everybody, a warm welcome to One and All. I'm Abhilash Chandra from the Department of Business Studies in Vidyashram PU College, the Temple of Excellence. Yes, finally you people have decided and you are in a right place. You had a dilemma that what am I supposed to take after 10th? This is what it is. Commerce is always the better choice. The reason is it deals only with something that the entire world deals with, that is called money and time. And here you people have a great opportunity to actually inculcate the both of these resources, that is money and the time. We're gonna teach you how to balance the money and the time, the value, what exactly you people need to know. That is what Abhilash sir will teach you in the entire session, students. So congratulations to all the students who have joined commerce, and Vidyashram always greet you with the open heart, and we tell you that yes, we are one family. Now here I'm gonna teach you about a subject which is so beautiful in commerce, that is business studies. And here in business studies, what exactly we're gonna go with the first kind of a thing, that is the introduction. What exactly this introduction is all about. I'll teach you how to make money. I'll teach you how to create money. I'll teach you how to create job. I'll teach you what exactly you should be in your life. Are you supposed to be an entrepreneur, or you wanna be something called an employee in a big firm? Everything I'm gonna go with one-to-one, and I'll tell you what is best in your life. And the rest thing is what you people need to decide, that what you want from life. Right? So the introduction of this chapter, it goes like this. We have a textbook which is prescribed by the NCERT. What is this NCERT? That means National Council for Educational Training and Research. These people have actually given you a prescribed textbook which exactly looks like this. You don't need to buy any reference textbooks, because Vidyashram is always a student-centric, which gives you the entire notes, the question papers, the answer paper, whatever you need as a student, we're gonna give you. Now, when I say question paper, it is not the board question paper which we're gonna give you. We're gonna give you all model question papers, students. This is what we do. Here in this textbook, what it is, what exactly the textbook has, you are supposed to know. Now we'll go with this. What is the first thing what we need to know? The first thing is syllabus. What we need to know? Syllabus. Guys, syllabus is something which is like a complete blueprint. Complete blueprint. And this is like a Kurukshetra kind of a thing. That is, you should know what exactly it is. In this textbook, we have the following subjects. In this textbook, we have the following chapters. What are the chapters? You have the first chapter, because it is through the business kind. So you have the first chapter called as the nature and purpose of business. The nature and purpose of what? Business. What exactly business is? And what is the purpose? Why should anybody go with business? That is what you will understand. Followed by the second chapter, that is here called forms of business. How many types of business are there? What all are the business? Can we do these kind of business or we cannot do? What are the procedure for having a business? Everything you will learn in the second chapter. The third chapter, now we are moving in detail. What are we doing? We are not just thinking about one point of a business. Here we are going with what every kind of a thing, that is in foreign, how a business runs, international market, what exactly it is, MNC, multinational company, means who are the company, what are the types of business we have. So you will understand about private, public, and what global enterprises. Now here is something which you have an opportunity that you will know more than a country's business, that is the entire world business, because it is all globalization is there. Now the next thing here is business services. Now we got to know what are businesses in these three chapters, right? Now the fourth chapter is all about the services given to the business. What is it? The services given to the business. And next we have something called emerging mode. That is what the 21st century, what exactly happens? What are the businesses which will be in a boom? Which are the businesses which you people shouldn't do in few of the seasons? Everything you will understand here. Emerging mode of business. And then you have something called social responsibility. What is this, sir? You spoke about business, you spoke about how to go with the business, the types of business, all those things. Here we got to know MNC company and everything. Here we have got to know that services are a must, because without any services you will not go and you will not buy any product. That's the reason the business people are throwing you what? Services. Here it's all done, sir. You told us everything, but what is this social responsibility? Why should I know about the social responsibility of a business? And here something is there called business ethics. Sir, why should I learn it? I'll tell you guys. See, those MNC company are actually utilizing more resources. What we people, a common man, should actually use it. What is their in return gift to the mother nature or to the people who are there, that is we people, like common, what are they supposed to do? They need to have something called responsibility, and that is what a business is, and this is called the ethics, that is their moral values. That means you should always have a morality towards the nature as well as your own species, that is the Homo sapiens. Next, here I'll tell you how to form a company, that is formation of a company. You people have heard about all the companies, Infosys, how Infosys was formed, how Microsoft was formed, how Tata company was formed. Everything I'm gonna teach you here, and you will have something called case studies, where I'm gonna give you so many case studies and we will actually solve it together. It is not like I'll dump all the case studies, we'll solve it face to face, we'll actually come one by one, we're gonna solve all the case studies of the company. This chapter is so interesting, I'll tell you. Right now, next you have, see, the totally in this textbook you have how many chapters? 12 chapters. Now these are the next one, that is how to get finance, because I told you, right, we can have so many kind of a business, all those things, but the question is, sir, how to get money for our business? So here I'll teach you how to make money, how to generate money, so that we can start our business, from where all you can actually take money. That is what the chapter is all about. Here I'll teach you. Now we're gonna start as a baby step, small business, right? We don't want to be like, see, even Microsoft, Apple, when they started their business, it was all what? Small business. You will be surprised, students. Apple and Microsoft, they started their business in a garage. In a garage. You all know this company, right? BMW. I'll tell you what this BMW acronym is. This company, that car manufacturing company, that was started in, now you are supposed to do all these Google Geekle kind of a thing. Your Abhilash sir will tell you everything, because we are equipped. In the sense, whatever you're gonna ask us, we'll have the answer. We don't Google. The reason is we have researched so many times and then we know what exactly it is. You'll be surprised what BMW is. Barisi Motoren Werke. What is it? Barisi Motoren Werke. It's a German company which was started in a garage. Now what BMW is? The minute you see BMW, you'll go with the series. It's a 5 series, 6 series, 7 series, 8 series. You go with what? The series. But now it is called as Bavarian Motor Works. What is it? Bavarian Motor Works. Now even they started as a small business. Now where exactly they are? Now next you have something called internal trade. Internal trade means within the boundary of India. That is called internal trade. That is something called internal external. You all know, right? So internal trade. Next we'll go with what? International. The 11th chapter and the 12th chapter deals with two of the subjects, that is the entire subject I'm telling you, which is in the degree. Here you have it as a chapter, that is International Business 1 and International Business 2. This is what the blueprint of your syllabus is. Moving on, we have chapter wise weightage. Students, here is something which I need to actually tell you what exactly this weightage is all about, okay? How you have written your 9th, 10th, right? That is totally different from how you will write your first PU and the second PU or your 11th standard or 12th standard. Here I'm telling you, we are only going with smart way. Many of you, you did not know where to concentrate more, where you're not supposed to concentrate, how to take it lightly, how not to take it lightly. The reason is your faculty wouldn't have told you. The reason I'll tell you what they would have told you is you need to learn everything, whatever is there in the textbook. But Vidyashram is not like that. We're gonna teach you everything, but I'll tell you where you are supposed to be a little more careful, where you are supposed to be very smart so that you will understand everything. Please understand what we have done this. This weightage is a new concept for you, right? I've given in this particular thing, first chapter to sixth chapter, okay? Here I am giving you the sessions, that is number of hours which I'll be taking for you people. That is here 4, 6, 3, 5, 3, 3, all those things. You leave this hours to me. I'll cover your portions. Here is something which you need to understand. Right, in the first chapter, let's go with this, right? Just a quick kind of a comparative statement. In the first chapter, you will get 7 marks. In the second chapter, you will get 19 marks. So, which chapter you are supposed to look carefully and understand? I'm telling you, both the chapters you need to be very careful. The reason is what? 19 and 7, it is how much? 26 marks. That means, 2 chapters, if you are thorough, then how much you will get? 26 marks you will get. But how many hours you need to spend? Only 10 hours. 10 hours of Abhilash sir's sessions. Or 10 sessions of Abhilash sir, and you get how much? 26 marks. Understand, right? That is what it is, students. For a PU, what exactly happens, I'll tell you. Out of 100, 35 is a passing marks, okay? But Vidyashram is not keen about the passing marks. The reason is, I'm damn sure that you will actually get more than 85 marks if you just go with few of our classes. But what I want to do is, I don't want you people to actually score 98 also. The reason is, when we can get 100, why to be happy with 98? And that 100 also, in a smart way, I'm gonna teach you and you will get it for sure. Just follow our instructions, right? Now, here is the total marks. So understand the total marks combination. Now, you have the pattern, you have a question paper pattern. You need to understand the pattern also. That is, you have a 1 mark question, 2 mark question, 4 mark question. Here 1 mark is there, 2 mark is there, 4 mark is there. Here next you have 8 marks and 5 marks. Here I have written something called POQ. This POQ I'll come back in the next sessions. What exactly a POQ is all about. Here you got this, right? What a POQ is all I'll tell you in the later classes. Now 1 mark. If you understand, all the 6 chapters have what? 1 mark. That means what is business? What is trade? All this easy questions you will get. You will write all the answers properly. 2 marks are there. Here again, all the 6 chapters you have what? Each 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. It's there. Now understand, here is what you need to understand. Smartly you are supposed to go and you are supposed to study. There is no hard work or you need to work hard. It is not like that. It is only what? Smart way and the smart work. Here if you understand, the second chapter, they do not have any 4 mark question. That means you shouldn't actually go with any of the topic and prepare it for 4 marks because you don't have anything. But whereas in this you have what? You have a 8 mark question. You have a 8 mark question. That means there are 2 questions which will come for 8 marks. So you need to concentrate that particular chapter. This is what the blueprint is. Now you can actually analyze what exactly it is. You have the 4th chapter, 15 here. Now understand, 7 plus 19, it is 26. 26 plus 15, your pass. You got it. And how many hours it is? Here 4 plus 6 plus 5, total 15 hours, 15 sessions, 15 days. If you are with Abhilash sir, you will get more than the passing marks. I'm telling you, don't be a person who want only little. When you can aim for something, when you can dream for something and you can achieve for something, right? Then what you are supposed to do? You need to get something like this. 100 on 100. This is what you are meant. This is what you are not, right? This, anybody can get student, but this is what the all the Vidyashram students will get if they follow the sessions properly. So this is what the weightage is all about. And if you can see this POQ, practical oriented question, you don't need to write too many things, right? This is a 4-mark question where you are supposed to explain in a, what, it's not like a short answer, you are supposed to go with a lengthy answer. And the 8 marks is that this is called the essay type question. What is it? Essay type question. This is all essay type question where you will need to elaborate it and then you are supposed to write. And the POQ is only you need to list down all these things. The next one is here you have chapter 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Exactly the same way of calculation. Please understand the weightage and all. Number of hours, please concentrate here. 4 hours and you will get how much? 7 marks. But why this 4 hours and 7 marks? The reason is you need to know the base. When your basics are proper, right? When the foundation is proper, what happens is then you can actually construct more buildings. That is why we do what? We go with a slow study. That is 4 hours fine, but still what? 7 marks. Not even 1 mark you are supposed to lose. That is what is our intention. And if you go with here, right? How many marks you will get? So if you understand the second chapter and the first chapter combination was there, right? 6 hours and 4 hours. Now here you have 4 hours and 7 hours. That means total 11 hours. But how much marks it is? You will again get how much? 26 marks you will get it. Now 26 and 26, how much it is? See, understand, this is where the smart way actually is applied here. So these are the things where you have, again, see, in all the chapters you have 1 mark. In all the chapters, you have 2 marks. Again, here you don't have 4 marks. But here you do have 4 marks. Here there are few chapters where you don't have 8 marks. Okay. So you will understand. Totally there are 6 8 mark questions. How much you should write? Again, there is a cutoff. Again, there is a cutoff. All practical oriented questions are there. There are totally 12 practical oriented questions. In that, how much will come? Again, there is a cutoff, which I will be explaining it to you. Here, let's go with this. In this, what exactly it is? Understand, guys. This is called section-wise question papers. That is the questions in the question paper. How much questions you will get and how much you are supposed to write. I told you there are like 1-mark question, 2-mark question, 4-mark question, 8-mark question and POQ, that is practical oriented question. That means 5 parts are there. Namely, A, B, C, D and E. In that, what it does, in the section A, you have 12 questions, but how much you are supposed to write? You are supposed to write only 10. That means what? Even if you leave 2 of the chapters, still you get 10 on 10. So understand, there are 12 chapters. Next here is section B, wherein you have 12 questions to be answered, but how much you are supposed to answer? You are supposed to answer only 10. That means what? Still, 2 questions if you leave, again, you get how much? 10 on 10. That is what it is. That is 20 is what it is. 10 into 2 is how much? That is 20 marks you'll get. Here, 10 into 1, how much you'll get? 10 marks. 10 plus 20, how much it is? 30 marks. That means what? You should only concentrate on the chapters which you are comfortable with. But I'll tell you, we have a long way to go. We'll cover the entire first POC in a clean sheet, where you will understand that this is very easy because that is a base for your degree and master degree. Here the next, when we come to the section C, what exactly we have in section C? Totally there are 10 questions. How much you should write? You should write only 7. Don't you feel that it's all a smart way? Next coming here, we have section D. Totally how many questions are there? 6 questions. How much you should write? You should write only 4. That means what? Still 2 questions you are actually leaving it. Next, section E is there. That is called practical oriented question. Totally how much it is? You had in all the chapter, you had one on practical question. Then I'll tell you which are the questions which you are supposed to be very, very calculative, and then which one you are supposed to go. What exactly it does? It is like here. Three questions will be given in the question paper. In that, how much you should accelerate? You should accelerate only two. Here, understand the smart way what you have done. In your 10th and 9th, how you are preparing yourself, it is totally different from the way you prepare for the centum in the first PU. Totally in the question paper, you have how much? 43 questions. How many questions? 43 students. But how much you are supposed to attempt to get 100 on 100? It is only 33 questions. Out of 43 questions, how much you are supposed to attend? 33 questions. If you attend this 33 question, students, you will get 100 on 100. Now, that is what? A sure assurance from Abhilash sir, because I'll teach you how to get this centum in a very smart way. Right? Now, we all have something. That is a pattern. What is this pattern? I told you about the five sections, right? Understand the pattern here. The first pattern here, section A, you have. Now, section A has something called 10 marks, one question. That is like 1 marks ka 10 questions you have. That is 10 marks. Now, section B, you have the 10 again, 2 mark question. How much is 20? Next, you have section C. That is 4 mark ka 7 questions you are supposed, right? You get how much? 28. Understand the pattern. Section D, you have essay type question. What is this? Essay type question where you are supposed to write only 4 and you get 32. And the last one is the practical oriented question. Practical oriented question, that is 2 into 5. This is a 5 marks question. Here, this is a 1 mark question total. The total is what? Your 100. I'm telling you guys, I will assure you, I'll come 5 steps forward to teach you. I just want your cooperation. You just need to come 2 steps forward so that I can teach you and you can learn from it. Because I told you, the more you learn, the more you will earn. And then you will tell, thank you so much, Abhilash sir, is what you will actually tell in your reply. And I'll tell you guys, I am not a faculty, I am your friend, I am your brother, and you can actually trust me and you can be with me, and that is what Vidyashram will actually take care of you, and you are a family, we are a family. Thank you so much, and whenever you feel that you need to contact me, our college is always there. You can actually call us, message us, DM us, everything you can do, because we are 24/7 student centric. Thank you so much.